Hello, and welcome to KDAP News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Robert Brock, and in this year's final edition, we have KD Doc Widgets 2.0, an interview with author Sergio Martins. Tip of the month: no announcements, as there aren't many events happening in January. Resources, and some fun to wrap up the end of the year. In case you aren't aware, KDE Doc Widgets is a framework for custom tailored docking systems that was originally developed to improve docking in Qt. Since then, features have been added continuously, and the latest release of version 2.0 has seen a big leap. It now additionally supports other frameworks like Flutter and Slint. Today, I talk to the author of KD Doc Widgets, Sergio Martins, to tell us a bit more about the work he has done for the release. Hi, Sergio.
Hey, Robert.
What motivated this recent release of KD Doc Widgets 2.0 and its major rewrite?
Well, plain and simple, the reason was Qt Quick. Version 1.7 already supported Qt Quick, but it was experimental. It was very, very hard to maintain the code. It was a nightmare for me. I mean, from the user's perspective, it worked fine, but each time I had to fix a bug, it would cause a regressions on the Qt widgets code. And when I fixed a bug for Qt widgets, it would introduce a regression in the Qt quick code. For this reason, I just had to rewrite everything, because people kept asking for feature requests that I could not implement anymore.
Mm-hmm. And why would you say the new implementation is better?
Yeah. So basically, I moved all the business logic to a separate library in pure C++, no Qt, agnostic to any GUI technology. Then I wrote a small library that just dealt with the Qt widgets rendering, in another library that just dealt with the Qt Quick rendering. But let me rephrase. In simple terms, the Qt Quick code is separated from the Qt widgets code. That means if I fix a bug for a customer that's using Qt Quick, someone that's using Qt widgets won't be mad at me because the code is isolated and there's no regressions introduced there.
Excellent, nice. What does the future hold?
So a really interesting side effect of this architecture is that now that the core of KD Doc Widgets is pure C++, no Qt, then the question is now, why don't we create KD Doc Widgets support for other GUI frameworks that are not Qt? So it should be possible, just pure C++. So we started playing with that, and we actually went quite far doing an implementation for Flutter and for Slint as well, which I think I can show you a little demo. Okay, let's do a small demo of all four technologies that KD Doc Widgets support. The oldest one, Qt Widgets. This is already known to you from version 1, but just to show you, it's not going anywhere. It will be supported forever. So in case you don't know what's docking, you can detach these windows, you can dock them back in, you can add them as a tab, and you have these classical Visual Studio type of docking indicators. So let's now see Qt Quick. Qt Quick was very experimental in version 1. Please don't use it and don't open a bug report. So it works the same way. Exactly the same way. The styling is just a bit different, but you can customize the styling however you like. Now it starts to get interesting. Flutter. So Flutter is interesting because it doesn't use any Qt at all. It just uses the C++ KD Doc Widgets library. So as you can see, the functionality is very, very similar. But there's just one thing missing. These windows, these are not really real top-level windows. They are fake windows. They are just a drawing on top of this main window. This is because Flutter does not support multi-window just yet. So I'm still waiting for them to finish the support. Then I can resume and finish the KDE Doc Widgets support. And finally, we have Slint. Slint is a bit behind. There's no drag and drop. There's no title bars. There's no tab bars. You cannot detach a window. Because Slint does not support multi-window yet either. And they are working on it and they will finish it. Then I can resume. But it's already using KDE Doc Widgets for layouting. So as you can see, you have like this multi-level recursive nested layout, which you can resize the Doc Widgets. So it's already reusing a big chunk of KDE Doc Widgets. But yeah, it will be done as soon as the Slint guys finish multi-window support.
That's awesome. Thank you, Sergio, for your time.
Thank you, Robert. Thanks.
To learn more about KDE Doc Widgets, you can read more via the links below the video, where there is a complete manual on GitHub, just to get you started. KDE Doc Widgets is available under GPL 2.0 or GPL 3.0, as well as under commercial licensing. I bet you have wondered at some point whether you could use different languages in one project, instead of having to choose one for the whole project. Our colleague Laurent Buchholder had the same thought and explored ways of mixing C++ and Rust code in one application. In his blog post, he describes his thought process and how he resolved the issue. Spoiler, he's using language D as glue. The most obvious reason that compiled programming languages can't just interact with each other is syntax. C++ compilers don't understand Rust, and Rust compilers don't understand C++. Thus, neither language can tell what functions or classes the other is making available, and the biggest challenges here are name mangling, data layout, and standard libraries. If you want to know how Laurent approached these challenges, you can read the blog linked below. Another publication that looks at how to integrate C++ and Rust code is the late edition of our Best Practices White Paper series, Building Hybrid Rust and C++ Applications. We consulted Rust experts and practitioners within our engineering department, as well as at Ferris Systems, an internationally recognized Rust consultancy. The paper presents guidelines and advice on combining Rust and C++ across a variety of scenarios and can be found below. Last but not least, Meeting C++ has started to release recordings of talks from this year's conference. We've linked the playlist below for you. And that was it for this year. Well, almost. Stay tuned for some fun we had whilst making this year's YouTube content. And otherwise, stay safe and feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. Happy holidays, and we'll see you next year.
QT or Stack Part 2.
I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world.
I feel like a criminal.
Et l'assistante maquillage, elle arrive quand?
Made of plastic, it's fantastic.
Bless you. Hello, my name is David.
I hope this content has been...
So, Andrew, another question we often received was... Trust me, I can English.
Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for... things.
You can subscribe for more videos about Qt, C++ and KDAB 3D on the KDAB channel.
That went too quick. Read more about it in the blog linked below.